Hi everyone, it's Miss Nikki Ann. I was almost reluctant to make this video because it has been such a very disheartening week and experience as far as healthcare is concerned. My heart is so heavy. I was in the hospital yesterday, and so let me just start the story of my week. And it's funny, but I think it seemed as if everyone had a bad Tuesday, which was, I think, the worst day of all for me out of the entire week. And so when I saw everyone else's videos, I was like, wow, it's just not a good day for anyone with dysautonomia. So Monday, I had my annual appointment with my neuro-ophthalmologist. Went great, 3-hour appointment, total workup because I'm on Plaquenil and it can make deposits in your eye, and I've gone blind before. And I was explaining to him that my rheumatologist was concerned about giving me a script while she's on maternity leave for my infusions. And then he was like, why? You have dysautonomia. You know, this is a saline solution. You guys need this, and it's only saline. And I was like, well, she's afraid that if something happens and she's out and none of the partners know about dysautonomia. I said that one line, and next thing I know, he went ballistic. No one knows. I know everyone in that practice, everyone, and I've taught them everything that I know about dysautonomia. And then he started running down the names, and he was right, those are all the people in the practice. He's just like, unacceptable that you can't. So he's like, this is what I need for you to do. I need for you to call your GI, he said him by first name because they're both within the same hospital. I need for you to call the GI and tell him that you need a script for this, and we'll just bypass rheumatology and get it that way, because my GI, of course, treats my gastroparesis and slow gastric emptying and whatever else is happening. Fine. So I'm like, oh, okay, you know, I said, but I do have an appointment with the POTS specialist that I've been looking forward to. It had been rebooked, but I'm finally able to go. And this, I was telling him this on Monday, so I'm finally able to get in with him tomorrow. So I'm hoping that maybe he can help resolve the issue. And my neuro-ophthalmologist is like, call Dr. such and such, call Dr. GI and tell him what I said. And I think even if you just call, you know, his nurses, you'll be able to get your script, Nikki. You know, fine. Even though there was some funny stuff with my eyes, but they couldn't necessarily say it was connected to the Plaquenil deposits. But still no significant change. And I was even saying to him, I'm getting older, don't I need glasses? He was like, what, 2020 is not good enough for you? But, I've never worn glasses, and I just assume because the losing my sight has nothing to do with 2020. It had nothing to do with that, but I'm always determined that I must need glasses. It has nothing to do with that. So, fine. Tuesday, big day. I'm excited. Guys, I have been researching, listening to you guys, reading research papers. I was so prepared for this appointment that I had started courting this POTS specialist named Dr. Jeffrey Kluger. He's affiliated with Hartford Hospital. He's a cardiologist who specializes in POTS. I'm saying all of that because I want his name out there. Dr. Jeffrey Kluger, cardiologist specializing in POTS, supposedly. So, I get all my stuff ready. I mean, I was up until late, and I don't stay up late because it affects me so much. And I have this big packet ready because I've been to so many specialists. I mean, I've been doing this since 2004. 2004. I've been fighting this battle since 2004, but 2008 when these symptoms came about. The first battle started with just the symptoms, but hadn't lost my vision yet, you know, until 2006 when I lost my vision. But so, we're ready, and we rescheduled so many things for this appointment and got someone to watch my six-year-old because my dad was at work and my mom was coming with me. She always goes with me to the most important appointments. And we get there, I'm filling out everything, and the nurse comes out. And the I've already checked in with the receptionist, okay, you know. And matter of fact, they had called me maybe earlier that morning to say, if you could come in just a little bit earlier, we forgot to send your paperwork or whatever, come in early to fill that out. I was like, yeah, I was gonna come in early anyway. I always get there early for a first visit just in case there's a lot of paperwork. So the nurse comes out, she's like, I'm so sorry, we're going to have to reschedule you. He's double booked. I'm like, this is the reschedule from the other double booked. She's like, really? I'm like, yeah. She's like, we're gonna have to reschedule. I have, see, people like that don't know your journey. They don't know all it took you to get, all the stuff that it took to get you to that appointment. Okay, and so he requested, you know, files from everywhere. I have so many doctors that I was running around like a crazy person for the past couple of months, getting files, doing this, doing that, only to not even get a response from him. It took my rheumatologist calling him to get the appointment that I got. So it wasn't even like I got it on my own merit. He was still reviewing my files, waiting on more files. If months have gone by, you haven't gotten all the files, shouldn't you contact the patient to say the doctors aren't sending what they're supposed to send? Because I called. I'm like, you guys getting all my stuff? She's like, oh no, we still need this, that. Why didn't you call? So I had it, and I said to her, you know, I don't feel at all comfortable with him handling my health. This right here has not proven to me that he is fit to be my doctor. And I said, by the way, I know a lot of people in the dysautonomia community, and I know a lot of specialists and very important doctors here in Connecticut. I said, and they will be getting notice that Dr. Jeffrey Kluger, associated with Hartford Hospital, cardiologist specializing in POTS, a little potsy himself maybe, I don't know. But all I know is I walked in with my walker. I was so sick and left that appointment that I had been anticipating and preparing for so long, hoping to finally get some answers. I had put everything I had on that because he was the last specialist in Connecticut on the list. And I've already been out of state for dysautonomia specialists, and that is not working. But that wasn't it. It couldn't have been that simple. Nothing really is. So I'll continue my story about my week in the next video. Dr. Jeffrey Kluger, associated with Hartford Hospital, cardiologist and supposed POTS specialist. I don't know because I never did actually meet him myself. But he did not even come out to the waiting room after double booking twice on me. He didn't even come out to say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. The same way the next day, which was yesterday, when I had an incident at my last appointment yesterday, my doctor came out to the waiting room to see about me. That's what you do with patients who have really serious chronic illnesses. This wasn't like just a regular checkup. This is a person who is suffering with something so debilitating. You couldn't come out to apologize for yourself. Because it doesn't matter who in the practice made the mistake. It doesn't matter. Your name is there on the front. Your name represents that whole place. And you should have come out after all that time. I had I've still not met you to be able to say that pursuing you as a specialist is worth anyone's while.